Welcome back into the Sports Source. This segment of our program brought to you by Southeast Termite and Pest Control. Termite control, bed bug control, year-round and seasonal pests like carpenter bees, stink bugs, ladybugs, mosquitoes. Now wildlife too. These guys take care of your home, your yard, your business. They can handle it all, home or residential. Southeast Termite and Pest Control. Trust your home to the family-owned business of Southeast Termite and Pest Control. All right, as T. Martin returns to Knoxville, a pair of coaches are leaving. First of all, John Lilly, who was an off-field coach this past year, titled simply assistant to the head coach. He had a long resume, has worked with Florida State, worked with Georgia, had been with the NFL. He's now going to work with the Cleveland Browns, so he's off the staff. A lot of people very impressed. There was some talk about him possibly getting an on-field role this offseason at Tennessee. So that's an off-field guy that's leaving. But also, I believe VolQuest broke the story yesterday that Charles Kelly would indeed be leaving Tennessee to go to Alabama to take a role on their defensive staff. He, of course, coached safeties and special teams coordinator at Tennessee. Another long track record of success had been the Florida State defensive coordinator after Jeremy Pruitt left there. So those guys are gone. Let's take a look at what the staff makeup looks like. The gold on the left, that's last year. The white on the right, that's your, kind of your question marks on what you're looking at this year. Ty Hilton gone. Your offensive coordinator is going to be Jim Chaney. We all talked last week. Chuck, you weren't here, but the rest of us all said that you've got to use him as quarterback coach with his resume. Would you agree with that?
Yes.
Okay, you agree that?
Yes.
Yeah, that, okay. Running backs, there's been talk that Chris Winkie could go. Wide receiver, there's been a lot of talk about David Johnson possibly going to LSU or Auburn. Might want to keep an eye on that one. We'll get back to that in a second. Brian Niedermeyer has done a really good job at tight end. Offensive line, Will Friend. Now you got T. Martin on the offensive side of the ball there. You don't know what he's going to coach. Defense coordinator, inside linebacker that stays Kevin Shearer. There was some concern that he may go with Mel Tucker to Colorado. Doesn't look like that's going to happen. Co-defensive coordinator, outside linebacker coach Chris Rumpf will be back. Defensive line coach Tracy Rocker looks like he'll be back. 98 team member Terry Fair back for the cornerbacks, you would think.
Not a 98 team member.
Oh, you're right. You're right. He left in 97. He missed it. You're correct. And that's why VFLs will be more critical in the media than they will in the 98 guy. You are correct. He left in 97. All right. Then you got safety, special teams coordinator. But here's the thing. Does Jeremy Pruitt take over there? Do you wind up with – I mean, you could have – you now get 10 on-field slots. You could wind up with 6 offensive and only 4 defensive if Pruitt kind of – and he worked with the defensive backs this past year. Does he do more of that? I say keep an eye on David Johnson there, guys. I still think there's a chance he leaves. It just seems to me that – just guessing. Johnson might already have a deal in place, might have said I'll stay here and recruit through this time. Pruitt knows that, goes and gets T. Martin. T. – you're our new wide receivers coach. Chuck, would you agree? You mentioned T. Martin and receivers.
Yeah, even through signing day. And that would open the door for that. Special teams, don't you think you'd want to talk to Terry Fair a little bit about if you're going to add some more responsibilities to what he does? So I think, yeah, I think there are some things they know that are going to happen, and everything's going to eventually sort itself out.
Just to play devil's advocate, I think Chaney would be a great quarterback coach, but you also got Winkie who could coach quarterbacks. Yep. You got T. Martin who could coach quarterbacks, and Chaney has coached other positions. Now, that said, you probably still want Chaney coaching your quarterbacks.
Yeah, there's only one guy on that staff that coached Drew Brees, Kyle Orton. You know, so to me, that would be the guy you go with.
Put Nathan Peterman in the NFL.
Put Nathan Peterman in the NFL. Yeah.
So.
Thoughts on, let's say it stays as is. Let's say Johnson doesn't go and Winkie doesn't go and it stands pat. Your thoughts on the 6-4 split on your coaching staff?
Well, I think you really would not have a 6-4 split because you do have Jeremy Pruitt more involved with the defense. I think if it does stay 6-4, then what you said earlier is what's going to happen. Pruitt is going to become more involved with the secondary on defense and would probably cover that hole there. So I think it would be fine.
Yeah, and I would add that it's still very much to be determined, right? Yeah. The way you laid it out, because as it is right
guessing,
now,
yeah.
Right, with the structure, you could make Winkie or T the quarterback's coach and have Jim Chaney kind of being a roaming coach on the offensive side. But if David Johnson were to leave, it makes more sense to me for T to be coaching wide receivers, which he's had a lot of success doing at different stops in the SEC and at USC. He was doing that while he was the offensive coordinator as well.
This is one that goes back and forth. Whenever Tennessee has not had a special teams coordinator by name, everyone says, oh, my God, we got to get a special teams coordinator. When you've got one, people go, man, you don't need one. You split it out. Where do you guys come down on that in terms of would you like to see one person as the designated special teams coordinator, or in your years of coverage, do you think it works just as well if you say, Coach Smith, you got the kick returns,
right.
Coach Johnson, you got kick coverage, et cetera, et cetera?
I would like to see a special teams coordinator.
One person.
Yeah, especially at this level. I mean, and who you're going up against and what they're looking at, how you do things. I think you pretty much need that. And who's going to be the onside's kick coordinator? You need to look out for that next year, too.
That'd be a busy man. That's right. All right, so most of these guys are one ring to rule them all. Do you guys agree you need one coordinator to rule the roost or no? Mike, you look like you're wavering.
I like that idea if you have somebody that you really believe can be great in that position. You do have more flexibility because the number of assistants you can have expanded a few years ago. So that gives you more flexibility.
Well, and the other thing is Tennessee now, and this is a Philip Fulmer change, that he went out and saw what they do at Alabama and at Georgia and said, all right, you've now got 56 quality control coaches. That also might alleviate things that you haven't had in the past that when you've got four guys over there who are pseudo coaches, you've got more people you can hand stuff off to. So that might help cover this. All right. Well, that's one to watch, or that's actually about 10 to watch in terms of going on up until signing day and then what happens after signing day. We'll have all that covered, of course. Later, we'll talk about has this been a feel-good start to 2019 for Vol football? I think you'd have to say yes, but we'll discuss with the table a little bit later. Up next, though, Tennessee's got two big basketball games this week. Why Vanderbilt might be dangerous even at 0-5 in the SEC. And then West Virginia and Bob Huggins come to town. Mark Pankratz, Mike Strange, they give you the scouting report next. Come on back on the Sports Source.